Continuing his call for tough justice against that jihadist that terrorized New York City, killed 8 on Tuesday. Now, the president tweeted, quote, NYC terrorist was happy as he asked to hang the ISIS flag in his hospital room. He killed 8 innocent people, badly injured 12. He should get the death penalty. He then followed up with 2 more tweets saying, would love to send the New York City terrorist to Gitmo, but statistically, that process takes much longer than going through the federal system. There's also something appropriate about keeping him in the home of the horrible crime he committed. Should move fast. Death penalty. Amen. Joining us now, reaction of the author of Defeating Jihad, former assistant to President Sebastian Gorka, also from the Islamic House of Wisdom, Imam Muhammad Ali Alahi. You think Iran is a good country, don't you, Imam?
So are you talking about New York or about Iran now?
I'm asking you a question. Do you think Iran is a good country? Do you not?
I know that somebody is fighting ISIS in the Middle East, Lebanon, Iraq, Iran, Syria. All of them are fighting ISIS, but your friend Netanyahu is helping them with medical services and air force. I know that.
I have a simple, basic question. Just to answer the question. Do you think Iran is a good country? Do you think it's run by good people?
Iran is a great country, Iranian nation, a great nation. Obviously, you know, it's thousands of years of civilization. But let us talk about the subject.
So let me say this.
Fear-mongering, Sean, and division and discrimination and bigotry and stereotype. You cannot make America great with this kind of mentality. We have serious problem. We need serious solution.
Serious solution. We have other guests. Dr. Gorka. They are one of the number one proxy war funder, exporter of terror in the entire world. And I know Imam Alahi is speaking from his heart. I've interviewed him before. He won't condemn this. How do we deal with their export?
You said
support,
the same thing about Saudi Arabia, by the
Dr.
way.
Dr. Gorka, and their support of radical Islamic terror.
Sean, when I came into the White House, I was brought in as a strategist to the president to work national security, but specifically counterterrorism. And my focus had been Sunni terrorism. Why? Because of September the 11th, Al-Qaeda, ISIS. I have to admit, with the briefings I received, with the meetings we had in the sit room in the NSC, over a very short period of time, I realized that we'll crush the Sunni extremists. ISIS is on the ropes. We're stacking them like cordwood. And I've come to the conclusion, Sean, that the bigger threat to America is the Shia jihadism of Iran.
All right, so then let me ask the Imam. Imam, is it wrong the way Iran practices Sharia law?
You know, now you are talking about Sharia law. Looks like President Trump is talking about Sharia law when he's talking about death penalty. What about Joseph Christian? What about James Alex? What about Stephen Paddock? You never ask me about this question.
We just had 8 people slaughtered. Let me finish, and I'll send it to Dr. Gorka. Allahu Akbar. That's what he said, which we hear all the time, Dr. Gorka.
Right. He shouted, God, Allah, is greater. And every single attack of significance, we see an individual who says they're a Muslim, they're a jihadi. We are not at war with Islam, but we are at war with people who say, I'm going to kill you because you're an infidel. That is the threat to America.
There is nothing wrong with Allahu Akbar, Sean. There is nothing wrong. That means God is great.
Why does it happen in every terror incident? Why do we hear it so often, like on 9/11 and like this week, there's 8 dead New Yorkers. I live in New York. I take it personally. 8 8 dead New Yorkers, many more injured. Why do we keep hearing it when there are these terror attacks? Why? Why does the country you support, Iran, talk about the death of America and the death of Israel and burn the American flag?
The problem, let me answer. The problem is not with God is great. You believe God is great, don't you? Dr. Gurka, do you believe God is great?
The problem is, listen, please.
The problem is with those people who don't follow God, don't follow Allah.
You mean like the hostile regime that is Iran, Dr. Gurka? Dr. Gurka.
Okay, let's be very clear here. We're talking about a regime that is a theocracy that says religion controls everything. We're talking about a regime that just now the Ayatollah said that the United States is its number one enemy. This is a hostile, aggressive regime that is destabilizing the whole region.
Funding terror.
From 1979, fighting terrorism.
Sebastian.
Well, Dr. Gurka, so many people are you very much. I know that you support Israel and you are more Israeli than Netanyahu. But there are a lot of people. who say that you are Nazi and you justify the genocide of Jews in Germany. Is that true? I mean, there are lots of
Dr. Gurka, all over. All right, let him talk, Dr. Gurka.
Well, Dr. Gurka, and they even question your citizenship because they say, Dr. Gurka.
There are a lot of people who've said very nasty things about me and the president, and I would be very, very concerned if the New York Post, Politico, BuzzFeed, CNN said nice things about me, because they're not interested in the things that I'm interested when it comes to the safety of this nation.
But you, Dr. Gurka, you never called a guy who keeps...
When we come back, you ever think...